In this part and the next part, we will explain or introduce a method of estimating the stage-discharge relationship by solver in Excel, and that is through the availability of data on the river discharge values and only two values for the rise in the water level in the metering station on the river or gauge height. One of the two values is at a low discharge value and the other value is at a high discharge value, where we will make an initial prediction for the values of the water level in the station or gauge height for the rest of the discharges through interpolation using the two known values of the water level in the station or gauge height at the low discharge and the high discharge, and then calculating the initial parameters of the relationship between the level and the discharge or the stage discharge relationship, and then a final prediction of the water level values at the station or the gauge height will be made for the rest of the discharges using solver in the Excel program, and the final relationship between the level and the discharge or the stage discharge relationship will be obtained as follows. Here in Excel, we have observation data for the water level and the station or gauge height and the actual discharges at this gauge height and the number of the observed data are 23. Usually, the observation data for the water level is in the station or gauge height are not available. So, if we have only two values for the rise in the water level in the metering station on the river or gauge height, one of two values of two values is at low discharge value, which is 0.61 meter at a discharge of 3.71 cubic meter per second, and the other is at a high discharge value, which is 5.49 meter at a discharge of 677.87 cubic meter per second, as we see. First, we will make an initial prediction for the values of the water level in the station or gauge height for the rest of discharges through interpolation using the two known values of water level in the station or gauge height at the low discharge and high discharge as follows. we go to the next column, and for the title we type weight to height. Then in the next column we type width to low. Then we calculate the values in the weight to height column as follows. We type equal, then between brackets we type the value of discharge in the same line minus the value of low discharge as the known values of the water level in the station or gauge height, which is 3.71. then we divide the all over the difference between the high discharge and low discharge at known values of water level in the station or gauge height, as we see. Then we calculate the values in the weight to low column as follows. We type equal, then between brackets we type the value of the high discharge at the known value of the water level in the station or gauge height, which is 677.87, minus the value of discharge in the same line. Then we divide the all over the difference between the high discharge and the low discharge at the known values of the water level in the station or gauge height as follows, as we see. Now we calculate the initial values of the water level and the station or gauge height for the rest of discharges through interpolation. we type equal, then we type equal the high value of gauge height, which is 5.49, multiply the value of the width to high in the same line, plus the low value of the gauge height, which is 0.61, multiply the value of the width to low in the same line as we see. By that, we have calculated the initial projection for the values of the water level in the station or gauge height for the rest of the discharges through interpolation. To make a comparison between the actual values of the gauge height and the initial projection for the values of the gauge height, we go to the next column and we type error or difference. Then in the next column, we type square error or square difference. Then we make the computations as we see. Then the sum of the square error or square difference between the actual values of the gauge height and the initial prediction for the values of the gauge height appears, which is 6.445. to obtain a more accurate prediction for the values of the gauge height than initial prediction for the values of the gauge height, we use a relationship between the discharge and gauge height and this relationship is as we see here in this equation. Which is Q equal CR multiply between brackets G minus A to power beta, and we will make the calculations by using this equation or relationship in the next part. To find the coefficient of determination or R squared coefficient between the actual values of the gauge height and the initial prediction for the values of the gauge height, we make a chart between the actual values of the gauge height and the initial prediction for the values of the gauge height. As we see, then in the chart we press on add trend line, then we tick on display R squared value, then the initial R squared value is 0.9659. And as we said, we will make the calculations by using the equation or relationship between the discharge and the gauge height in the next part.